Hey everyone! Welcome back to a brand new video on my channel. Today we're embarking on a fascinating journey through the rich history of Afghanistan, delving deep into the greatest and most impressive empire the country has ever witnessed. Afghanistan has seen a lot over the centuries, and it's time to shine a spotlight on the epic tale of this mighty empire. So without further ado, let's dive into this historical adventure. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and let's explore history together. In the mid-18th century, Ahmad Shah Durrani, a charismatic Afghan military commander, rose to create one of the largest Islamic empires in the world. In the midst of the rugged landscapes of the Pashtun tribal regions, Ahmad Shah Durrani came into the world on October 14, 1722, during the mid-18th century. Born to humble beginnings, Ahmad was not destined for royalty. Rise as a warrior. As Ahmad grew, so did his prowess on the battlefield. In 1747, at the age of 25, Ahmad achieved his first triumph on the battleground. With a determined gaze and his trusted sword by his side, he led his troops in a military campaign that left an indelible mark on history. Ahmad Shah's charisma and strategic brilliance earned him the title Duri Durrani, symbolizing the pearl of his age. His exceptional courage and martial skills garnered recognition among Pashtun tribes, solidifying his path to becoming a formidable leader. After Ahmad Shah's triumph in 1747, his vision extended beyond the current borders of his Pashtun tribal homeland. His aspirations reached towards the conquest and consolidation of territories, culminating in the establishment of the Durrani Empire. It all began with strategic alliances. Ahmad Shah, a masterful diplomat alongside a skilled warrior, understood the significance of robust partnerships. He forged strategic alliances with influential tribal chiefs and leaders from surrounding regions. These alliances served as sturdy foundations for his expanding empire. Ahmad Shah's military campaigns were infused with strategic brilliance. He analyzed the weaknesses of rival powers and selected tactical objectives. The Battle of Panipat in 1761 was a turning point where Ahmad Shah not only achieved a military victory, but also seized the opportunity to expand his empire. The battle solidified his position as a formidable ruler, extending his influence over parts of Afghanistan, Pakistan, and India. The number of wars Ahmad Shah waged reflected his determination to expand his empire. He overcame obstacles, subdued rebellious territories, and asserted his authority over diverse populations. The cities of Herat, Kandahar, and Ghazni fell one by one under his rule, each with its unique challenges and triumphs. Ahmad Shah's military strategies were not only based on strength, but also on clever diplomacy, enabling him to secure local support and stability in the conquered regions. His ability to unite different regions under a single governance was crucial to the success of his expansion. As the Durrani Empire flourished, Ahmad Shah turned his attention to the development of grand cities. Kabul, the capital, became a beacon of architectural splendor. Palaces adorned with intricate designs, bustling marketplaces, and centers of learning flourished under his reign. The cultural exchange within the empire gave rise to a renaissance of art, literature, and philosophy. Ahmad Shah's enlightened rule fostered an environment where creativity thrived. The empire became a melting pot of ideas, a testament to the harmonious coexistence of diverse communities. As Ahmad Shah Durrani approached the later years of his life, his legacy cast a long shadow. The empire he had built, shaped by conquests and cultural exchanges, would have a lasting impact on the course of history. The narrative shifts to the later years, delving into how later rulers grappled with Ahmad Shah's legacy, the challenges they faced, and the ultimate fate of the Durrani Empire. This sequel can serve as a bridge to further explore how the empire evolved in later years, its eventual decline, and the echoes of Ahmad Shah Durrani's vision in the annals of history. As Ahmad Shah neared the end of his life, taking his last breath at the age of 50 on July 23, 1772, the story continued, with echoes of his vision resonating through history. This was the tale of the young warrior who rose to become a ruler, shaping the history of the impressive Durrani Empire. Thank you all for joining in on this historical journey. Don't forget to support me by subscribing and liking the video. Until next time.